So I'm gonna make a maple key necklace. Each piece is completely unique. I use one maple key, cover it with the silver. It's a powdered silver with a paper binder. So I'll do layers and layers and layers on this. Fire it, and then that piece is done, so I'll need another maple key to make another necklace.
I do jewelry, I do stained glass, I do sculpture, I do installation. Nothing traditional, always something a little different.
I would say it could take a good 2 full days of work to do 7 necklaces. Painting them, sanding them, firing them, assembling them, polishing them.
My inspiration comes from nature. Well, I lived in the city growing up, and I would come to the country for my summer holidays and had the best time of my life being in the country. My grandparents also had gardens, and they would always take us out wandering and always had us involved in nature, picking strawberries and raspberries. So some of my fondest memories are actually in nature. What gave me the idea for this installation? Well, the studio was empty. We were closed for the month of February. This beautiful empty space needed something in it. And I have developed a bit of a green thumb in the past couple of years and decided that this space would be the greatest space to have a big flower installation. I chose the hyacinths for their perfume, and it just worked out perfectly. They opened up the day of the vernissage. I wanted there to be different colors so the eye wouldn't just focus in one place. I wanted the eye to move all over. All this paper is from my grandfather's house. I collect wallpaper. This wallpaper was in my mom's bedroom and this was in my grandfather's bedroom. They used to look up at it every night. Most of the little pots in the front of the gallery have been hand rolled. I have a few little apple trees, a few little vegetable plants, but most of them are zinnias. I have some jars with little spreading pea shoots. The jars I also found in a recycle bin at a friend's house. She was a homeopathic doctor, and I love that little installation as well. So I'm constantly thinking of sprouting new things.
Well, I like to bring light and bright things out in the world. And it sort of manifests itself in art.